In this video, we are looking at the best video settings for the Autel X-Star. What's up everyone? So we recently bought an Autel X-Star and we needed to do some tests to see what would be the best settings to get the most out of the camera. It's a long video with a lot of testing and we are showing you pretty much all variables. So bear with me, and if you're in a rush and just want to get to it, the best settings are at the end of the video, or you can go to the blog. The link is in the description below. So here is what we'll do. First, we will test the settings in a controlled environment and do a short list. From that, we will try them in the real world and see which one gives you the best performance. All right, let's get started. So the first test we'll do is for the color profile. Is the log profile really worth it more than the standard or non-color profile? So this one is the non-color profile. Funny enough, when we bring the RGB parade, the waveform is only half of the spectrum when in the app. The whole histogram was used from 0 to 255. So I'm not too sure what is happening there since this appeared to be slightly underexposed now, but all the info is there. The only thing that doesn't show up is the red channel on the histogram in Premiere. It's almost clipping, which is probably why the Autel app histogram doesn't match. So here is the log picture profile. No settings change, but we can see how flat the picture became. Funny enough, you can see the red in the base of the cube that appears to have hotspot, even though the histogram wasn't showing anything in the app, and the waveform doesn't show anything either. We can also see that the red in particular has more range. For the rest of the image, again, no settings were changed, so it was exposed to the right a little bit. So if you would adjust the settings and expose it properly, most of these little burn-in may disappear. Side to side, you can see the difference, how log lifts the shadows. And then I just did a 5-second color correction on both. I would say log has an edge. It is not as much as high-end cameras, but enough to please anyone who knows how to color correct. It definitely has a better color rendition. For the color settings, the first test will be the color saturation setting. First, let's put them all next to each other, and you will notice that there are no -3 saturation settings. Since it turns the image black and white, we didn't include it. From the get-go, we can see that +1, +2, and +3 are oversaturated, and we don't want that, which leaves us with -2, -1, and 0. From experience, I'm pretty sure -1 will be the winner. Here, one after the other, with a quick match in saturation, they are all really similar. 0 seems to be oversaturated a little bit, especially with the greens and yellow. They are all good candidates, but -1 has a slightly better color rendition, control, and smoother gradient. Now that we've established that -1 has the best color saturation settings, let's move to the contrast. Contrast is a little bit different to test. First, we'll take the lowest settings and compare it with the highest settings and see if once color corrected, there's a big difference, if we're losing details and that kind of stuff. So here we have -3, then -3 corrected, followed by +3. The good news here is that -3 doesn't lose any details. In fact, if we punch in, -3 has a more detailed image than +3, and maybe +3 has better noise than -3, but that's really subtle. Again, that's not scientific, and you probably can't even see the difference on YouTube with the compression. +3 also has a tiny bit better contrast in the shadows, which makes me want to do more testing to see where is the happy medium. Here, one after the other, -2, -1, and 0. To me, -2 seems to be the best options of the bunch. It will give the image quality and contrast I want. The image quality seems to fall apart at 0. So if you're looking for the best image quality and you know how to color grade, -3 or -2 is your best bet. -2 appear to be the best option, but one or the other, they are really close. We are splitting hair here. And that is two variable set. We can start analyzing sharpness now. For the sharpness, we will do something similar to the contrast and compare both the lowest and highest settings next to each other and peel back from there. So this is -3 sharpness with a good amount of sharpness added in post, and this shot really lacks of detail and doesn't even come close to this shot, which is the +3 shot. From here, we can look at which settings brings us where we have enough details, but not overly sharpened. So we'll go from -1, 0, and +1 and add sharpness in post to see which one brings us closer to the +3. And that would be our winner, being the variable with the most range without degrading the image. From that test, -1, 0, and +1 seems to be good candidates. The caveat with -1 is that we need to add so much sharpness that the noise become more apparent. Okay, now for the second part, we will do the real life testing. From our findings, there are three combinations I want to try: 0, -2, -1, +1, -2, -1, and -1, -3, -1. If you're wondering why -3 contrast on the later one, is I just want to see in real life if there's a difference between -2 and -3, since in the control environment there was a really slim difference between the two of them. So here are all the shots next to each other. I would say 0, -2, -1 is the most appealing out of the box. +1, -2, -1 looks like it's over sharpened, and the -1, -3, -1 looks like it lacks detail. So this is 0, -2, -1 with a quick color correction on it. The noise is acceptable, good shot overall, but it appears to be a little bit over sharpened to me. As for +1, -2, -1, this is over sharpened and the noise is pretty noticeable. We can eliminate that option right away. -1, -3, -1 is not too bad color corrected, but it still lacks details, and all the sharpening in post increase the noise. Note that we need to introduce more contrast in this shot, as we had -3 contrast settings on this one, which turns out in real life doesn't do much more than -2 and just makes the screen harder to see outside. Now all the shots color corrected next to each other, so 0, -2, -1 is the top contender. We can eliminate +1, -2, -1. We are getting closer to deciding what is the best setting. So let's do a different test and let's add -1, -2, -1 and see which one is the top one. So now we have the two settings next to each other. Both are acceptable in my opinion. The thing is, in those conditions, with all the branches, the -1 sharpness seems smoother out of the camera, while the 0 sharpness looks like a little too sharp and has color fringing in the branches. It's like there's a big step between 0 and -1. The best setting would be -0.5, but it doesn't exist. Both would be good settings to use depending on what you're filming. For everyday filming, or if you're matching the footage to a camera with a lot of detail, definitely go with 0, -2, -1. But if you're matching the footage to a DSLR like a Canon 5D or Nikon D800, then -1, -2, -1 are the best settings to match those cameras. Also, I noticed that -1, -2, -1 doesn't render well on lower bitrate codecs. So if you're not planning to export your video in ProRes, for example, don't shoot with those settings, as the final export would look really bad when 0, -2, -1 will hold really well on a H.264 export. Another thing to note is that the footage has been taken at ISO 100 and 1/4000th of a second, as it was a bright day. If you're using an ND filter and lowering your shutter speed, 0, -2, -1 will be the one to use. Now, if you don't know how to change your settings, you need to go in the app, and at the bottom, there's a little wrench icon. In there, you'll see the color submenu. And if you're scrolling down, you will see log. You select that, then if you go back, there is a style submenu. This is where you can change the settings we talked about. All right, and that's it. The best settings for the Autel X-Star is 0, -2, -1. It will give you the best image possible from your drone. And if you're planning to use those settings, you can head over to the blog and get the color preset LUT to get the color you see here. I hope you liked this video. If you have any comments, leave them in the comment box below. As always, subscribe to the channel, find us on Facebook, and see you next time.